not postfix to infix conversion. Right? There is no special algorithm for postfix to infix conversion. We have to make use of the same algorithm, which is nothing but evaluation of postfix expression. The same algorithm is used. No different, no change, but one or two steps may vary. Right? Let us look at the example or the algorithm to convert the postfix expression to infix expression. The step one remains the same for both the evaluation of postfix expression and conversion of postfix expression to infix. The step one is you create an empty stack and start scanning the postfix expression from left to right. Okay. And then the second step is remains the same. If the element is an operand, push it onto the stack. Right. So as I told in the previous class, the stack that is being used for this evaluation of postfix as well as conversion of this postfix to infix is operand stack. Why? Because the name is given based on the contents which you are storing in the stack. In this algorithm, you are storing the operands inside the stack. Therefore, it is called as operand stack. But in the previous algorithms for converting the infix to postfix and for converting the infix to prefix, we are making use of operator stack. Why? Because we are storing the operators. Therefore, that stack is called as a operator stack. Right? So, there are some questions, direct questions which are asked on these particular topics. What is the type of stack that is used for converting the infix expression to postfix expression? It is an operator stack. Similarly, there is another question like what is the stack that is used for evaluation of postfix expression? It is an operand stack, right? Similarly, here also for converting the postfix to infix expression, since we are using the evaluation of postfix algorithm only, we are again making use of this operand stack only. Simple concept. So if it is an operand, push it onto the stack. If it is an operator OP, this is important. There in the evaluation, what you are doing, you are popping twice and then you are storing in operand 2 and operand 1 respectively, and you have to calculate operand 1, OP, operand 2, and whatever result you get, that should be pushed onto the top of the stack, right? The same thing happens here, right? If it is an operator, you pop twice and get operand 2. So whatever element that is popped first, it should be placed in, first popped element is placed in operand 2 and the second popped element is placed in operand 1, right? And you have to calculate this thing. This is the simple difference between these algorithms. You have to calculate this thing. Operand 1, OP, operand 2. This is not a result. You won't get any single value. You will get a string like A plus B or B star C. Like that you will get some string. So what you will do is after getting this string, you encapsulate the string within the parenthesis like this. You just add these parentheses, left symbol and right symbol, and then push it back to the stack. Right? This process should be repeated until the expression is ended. If the expression is ended, then the value that is present on the top of the stack will be the final answer. The same algorithm, no change, except that you have to convert it into a string and you have to add some parentheses. Right? So this is how we convert. Let us go for some examples here. This is the first example and this is the second example. Right? Right. So this is the postfix expression that is given, that is A, B, C star plus. According to the algorithm, you take a stack, empty stack. Okay, I have taken the empty stack. Let the size of this stack be just 3 elements with indexes starting from 0 to 2 and ending with 2. So you take the output, it's not output, right? So according to the algorithm, you scan the given postfix expression from left to right. If it is an operand, you push it onto the stack. If it is next, increment the pointer, it is pointing to B. See, it is also an operand, push it onto the stack. Increment, it is C, operand, push it onto the stack. Increment, now it is an operator, Now, according to step 2.2 of the previous algorithm, you have to pop twice the stack and then you have to make a string like this. So, you pop the first element and place it in operand 2. So, the operand 2 is nothing but string C, and you again pop it and the operand 1 becomes B. Right? You have to calculate a string like this. Operand 1 operator and operand 2. What is the operator here? We have the operator as star. Therefore, you have to make a string like this. It becomes B star C. After making the string, you have to encapsulate this string inside the parenthesis. And this is the result we have obtained. And you have to push back this thing again back into the. So this is removed and this is removed. Now you have to push back this expression into the stack. Now it becomes B star C. Right? After that, you increment the pointer. It is pointing to plus. Since it is an operator, again you make the same things like. Right. Now the operator is plus. The operand 2 is the first element that is popped, which is nothing but B star C. And the operand 1 is nothing but the second element that is popped, which is A. You make the string like this, that is operand 1, which is A, and operator plus, and then it is B star. Right. After that, we encapsulate the entire result into the parenthesis. Now what happens? This is removed, this is popped, and this is popped. And you have to push the new result onto the top of the stack, right? It becomes A plus B star C. Now you have reached the end of the expression. That is, whatever element that is present on the top of the stack is the correct infix expression. Therefore, for the given postfix expression ABC star plus, the correct or the corresponding infix expression is A plus B star C. Right? Very simple example. So there exists no shortcut method. You have to go for the conventional method only. You have to go for the stacks only. Right? Similarly, if you take this particular example, what happens? So it is A and it is B. Now you have come across plus, the next symbol is plus, and then you have to make the operation A plus B and push it onto the stack like this, and then we have C, we have D, and then it is star. Again, pop the elements and make the expression like this, which is nothing but C star D. And we have one more element E, and you have come across this one. Now what it becomes? So you remove it. It becomes by E. Now we have one more operator, that is minus. What you have to do? You have to pop these elements, right? So this is operand 2 and this is operand 1. It becomes A plus B. Operator is minus, and then it is C star D by E. Right? And then you push this result. Okay, you can remove the extra parenthesis, right? So this expression will be equal to A plus B minus C star D by E. Right. So this is how we convert the given postfix expression into infix expression, which is a straightforward algorithm with some modifications of evaluation of postfix expression algorithm. Right. So after this, the last topic which was asked by Manjunath is how to convert the prefix to infix.